Welcome to the Tintri Live Demo Series. This is a recorded version of the Tintri Storage Replication Adapter with VMware Site Recovery Manager session. SRM provides a framework for automated testing and disaster recovery failover. The Tintri Storage Replication Adapter allows SRM to communicate with Tintri VMstore arrays. This enables SRM to control the array functions necessary for test, failover, reprotect, and failback operations. Under the covers, SRM array-based replication leverages Tintri replication, which is branded as Replicate VM. Replicate VM increases replication efficiency by means of deduplication and compression. The blue line represents the actual network data transfer rate, about 30 megabytes per second in this example. The yellow line represents the logical data transfer rate, approximately 120 megabytes per second in this example, yielding an approximate 4-to-1 increase in replication efficiency. When array-based replication is operating normally, Replicate VM is leveraged to replicate periodic VM snapshots from the protected site to the recovery site. The frequency at which snapshots are taken is user-selectable, and we'll take a look at this in the live product in just a moment. When a recovery plan test operation is performed, users have the option to replicate recent changes to the recovery site. When this option is enabled, Replicate VM is again leveraged to replicate the recent changes to the recovery site. When a planned migration operation is executed, Replicate VM is used to replicate the most recent data at the protected site to the recovery site. When a reprotect operation is performed, Replicate VM is configured to replicate in the opposite direction, from the new protected site back to the new recovery site. When a failback operation is executed, Replicate VM is again used to replicate the most recent changes to the recovery site. The lab environment we'll be using for the live portion of the event looks like this. We've got two sites, the local site with a Tintri T5040 all-flash array is the protected site. The remote site with the Tintri T850 hybrid flash array is at the recovery site. This is an animated slide that depicts what we'll see in the lab demo. At the point where we initiate a failover operation, sync-generated snapshots will be taken for the VMs contained within the protection group. Replicate VM will be used to replicate the sync-generated snapshots to the recovery site. The VMs at the protected site are powered off. The sync-generated snapshots at the recovery site are used in conjunction with the placeholder VMs to create running virtual machines. Okay, let's start the demonstration. We'll review the existing replication settings to show that a replication path has been configured from the array at the protected site to the array at the recovery site. Next, we'll look at the Tintri service group we configured for use with SRM. Note that the service group state is failover primary and that it contains 7 VMs. We'll update the service group to look at the configuration settings. The service group name is SG10. It contains all the VMs on the data store named DS10. It replicates to the T850 at the recovery site. And the recovery point objective has been customized to occur at 5, 20, 35, and 50 minutes past the hour, every hour, every day. The schedule retains 1 hour of snapshots at the protected site and at the recovery site. The snapshots are configured to be VM consistent. Looking at the VMs, we can easily identify the VMs contained within the service group. Switching to the array at the recovery site, we see the replicated service group with a failover normal secondary state. The VMs are represented as synthetic images, which consist of replicated snapshots and placeholder VMs. Switching to SRM at the protected site, we take a look at array-based replication. Here we see an array pair configured on DPL VCSA-1, the protected site. Note that the pair is enabled and provides details about the local and remote array managers. Also note the replicated device group. This is the Tintri service group, SG10, we looked at a moment ago. We'll come back and look at recovery plans. Here we see recovery plan 10 with the protected site indicated as DPL-VCSA-1. We can drill into the recovery plan and look at the VMs it includes. Okay, we come back to the Monitor tab and click the Run Recovery Plan button. At this point, we click the I Understand box and note the recovery type is Planned Migration. We click Next and then click Finish. We can expand the recovery steps to get a better idea of what's happening. At this stage, SRM is creating sync-generated snapshots and replicating them to the recovery site. We saw this earlier in the animated slide. We'll switch to look at the array at the protected site. We select snapshots, sort by creation date, and refresh the display. Here we see the sync-generated snapshots that were taken at 6:02 a.m. We select the VM Store tab and view a real-time display of outbound replication traffic. Hovering over the graph, we see that the logical replication transfer rate is about 320 megabytes per second, and that the actual network rate is about 32 megabytes per second. Replicate VM is providing an approximate 10-to-1 efficiency factor in this demonstration. Switching to the array at the recovery site, we select the VM Store tab to view inbound replication traffic. Hovering over the graph, we view metrics similar to what we saw on the outbound side. We select virtual machines and then snapshots. After sorting, we can see the sync-generated snapshots on the recovery site array. Note that there is a sync-generated snapshot for each VM contained within the service group. Returning to SRM on the protected site, we can see that the VMs on the protected site have been shut down. Switching to the VMs and templates view, we can see that the 7 VMs in the service group have been powered off. When the display updates, we can see that the VMs now reside in the placeholder data store. Switching to the storage view, we can see the placeholder folder mounted as a data store. Drilling into a placeholder VM, we can view the related files, the VMX file, for instance. Let's go back to the recovery plan and see what steps are executing. At this point, SRM is powering on the VMs at the recovery site. We'll watch the recovery plan execute to completion, which should only take a short time. Okay, it's almost finished. At this point, we're waiting on VMware tools on the Windows 2016 guest. Recovery is now complete. We switch to vSphere at the recovery site. We select VMs and templates. Here we see the VMs have been powered on. We can also see that the data store is DS10, the one that was specified in the service group. At this point, we switch to the array at the recovery site and select the service groups tab. We see that SG10 now has a failover promoted secondary state. Clicking the Virtual Machines tab, we see the VMs and can correlate them to the service group. Back on vSphere at the first site, we return to SRM. Recovery is completed, and we'll begin a reprotect operation. We click the I understand box and continue. At this point, we again view recovery steps. The reprotect operation takes a few moments to complete, and we'll allow this to play out until completion occurs. Reprotect is almost complete. There it goes. we come back to the recovery plan view and can see that the DPL-VCSA-2 site is now the protected site. We switch back to the array at the new recovery site and select the Virtual Machines tab. We then select VMs and can see a combination of synthetic VMs and red-colored VMs. The red VMs represent a transitory state that occurs after failover, but before the reprotect operation is performed. Let's refresh the display. At this point, we see the fully formed placeholder VMs residing within the placeholder data store. Selecting service groups, we can see where the service group is replicated from and that the state is failover normal secondary. We switch to the array at the new protected site and select service groups. The service group state is failover primary. And here we see the VMs and their service group affiliation. In summary, integrating Tintri with SRM is a simple and straightforward process. Array-based replication enabled by Replicate VM increases replication efficiency. Tight integration results in a full-featured implementation. Thanks. For Tintri, this has been Bill Roth.